Happy days are here again. Oh, the happy days are here again. Make always a happy event. When you start painting, grab that big brush and make yourself happy. Even if you're not happy, but there's a way of, I always make myself, condition myself to, now I paint and I want to have almighty painting. It got to be a friendly painting. It got to smile at me, and then I have to smile. Naturally, if you get, if I smile at the canvas smiles back. See, and that is, makes it so nice. So I see already that lousy canvas. Look at that smile there, and the little eyes looking at me. And again, a happy mountain in the autumn time. Autumn. I got the magic right on. Please don't put too much magic red on. From now on, I will say it on every TV show. Don't put too much magic red on, because that will ruin your day. Just enough is a certain pull. I feel a certain pull already. I will have a kind of a... make it far in the back, the sky. Let it be maybe kind of a nice, happy morning. Kind of a happy morning. See, that comes up like that. And I will have a little bit of Indian yellow on that canvas. But you see how little I put on? I just rub it in. There you are. Now we come down with the blue from the top. Take a look how I take it off. Always just a nice brush, just like fog, like mist in the brush. Don't put a block on, then you get nowhere. And then you fire in from the top down into the to those colors. See? And I make a perspective sky. This way you get the sky deep. You create that illusion of a deep, deep sky. And that makes it so beautiful. Deep sky. See, it don't turn green on you, that blue, because if I had too much yellow, it would be greenish. But this way it just stays just on the border. It has a nice, nice color there. Good, good. Autumn. Think about the autumn time. Colorful. I just hypnotize it a little bit. Blend it in nice, so that's coming out of whatever. Good. Now I will create a couple happy clouds in there. Couple happy clouds in there coming over the hill. I will have a mountain in front, so we make it so this is just behind the mountain is a cloud coming up forwards. See, sometimes it's nice to have that light, because the dark mountain against that light, that will really show good. See, sometimes you look for just the opposite color there, and then you can create a sky like this. That is all right. So, now we fire up. You can just leave it like that. Very light clouds moving by. Very light clouds. You don't have to put even shadows in. Just leave it like that. And I will brush it out. Make sure, just like this. Little, make it a bit windy but fluffy, so it's soft, soften it up a little bit. Now we got a nice cloud in the back there ready. And now I use my almighty knife and that thick, thick paint up here, a bit more. Just put enough on to your mountain black, Alizarin crimson, Prussian blue. And then you mix it like marble. Mix it like marble. Bit more blue. That's it. I think that's it. I can see it already. See, when you paint so many paintings, you sense already the colors, what you think, the darkness or... I'd like to have a little bit autumn colors, a bit of blue there against blue there. See? That's kind of a color. That's nice. That is nice. Now then you can brush that out. Can leave it on the side, I will not put any more in. And you just, I put a little bit white on already here, I want to have it lighter there, see? Make it like out the mist, the mountain is coming right out of that mist there into that beautiful. There you are. See? Wonderful. Wonderful. Now you highlight that. Let the sun come up. Don't matter what side you want to use. It's always a better painting when you have a side movement of the sun, of the light. I will use this time the sun coming from this side. Then I put it off like this. See? Isn't that a beautiful move? He has this stroke. There's just a stroke you can sell. Yeah, now on the other side here, on this side here. And this side here. Beautiful. And the paint is breaking. That's the main thing. It gives me all the details, all the things I want. See, there you are. All the things I want. Have a bit more here on the outside. I push the knife down a little bit more on the outside there. See? That's nice. Now you can use the same heavy, thick white and a touch of blue into that. See what I do here? Just white and blue alone. And then you have to learn how blue is blue. Just a certain. As more you paint, as more you learn, a certain blue does a better job. See, I will use the other side. Use this side of the knife now and then just fire it off like this. Look at that. That makes it really nice. Here too. Oh yeah. That's the way of living. That is good living. Happy days are here again. Happy days are here again. You know, and the funny thing, when you paint like this, you get happier as you're on painting. because the colors and everything is just coming your way. Good, 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 good. Now I will put some light with the big brush. A thinner white. See, I have two types of white here, a thicker white and a thinner white. And I use a thinner white now, and I would like to bring it in from on the bottom. See how I do it? Look at that. See, loose, very loose. Can you see? Very loose movements there. Here the same, you can have it from here, going up there. There, look at that. Wonderful, wonderful. That light against dark, dark against light. Now, we talk about autumn colors. I will put some autumn trees in. I use orange this time. Orange and a little crimson together in that case here. And I fire in a powerful orange tree there. When you have orange already on the brush, then put all the orange trees in what you think there would be around there. May I put the other one in there? See, then you have all the orange trees together, and you don't have to wash the brush again and go on again and go on again. And if you even have one orange tree too much, that doesn't matter. You always can paint them over. You know, it's no problem to get rid of them. But autumn colors, I want to really, really bring out autumn colors here in this particular painting. See, look at that. And isn't that wonderful the way the branches are flying? Can you see the branches are flying around? This is just so loose and free, and it makes it nice. Now I will go leave that orange already and go into the yellow and white. Yellow and white, and try to get the other color there, here. The color there. Yellow. Yellow and white. Yellow and white brings it out nice. I just aim for colors now. Nice autumn colors. Nice autumn colors. Good. See? Oh boy, that's really coming good. Now watch, I go into the sap green, and I will take the green, the yellow trees and put shadows in the back. See, then it becomes a green tree, but with the light. The light is from this side. As a sample, I show you here with this one here. See? You mix all of a sudden green and yellow. See, and that makes a nice tree. Now I want to have more green trees. More green trees. Oh, maybe here's one right in between. Looks good. Other green tree. Oh, here maybe. That's good. Colors, colors, dark on the bottom. See all that shrubs, all the alders and whatever they are grown in the on the bottom here. And you. Make that kind of trees. Look how the branches are flying out. Isn't that wonderful? How you can do it with a big brush? Let the branches just fly out there. There we are. Oh, that would be a nice painting. Here against this. Oh, there you are. Now I will start doing a little bit like this. See, little happy little scratches. Oh, that's good. And then again, you play with colors. With almighty colors, white, touch of yellow, white and yellow. And I will just bring out that tree a little bit more. Something like this. Here I fire in a little bit light against the dark. Here we get this colors, aim for colors. Like, make a little valley here. Make a little valley there. That's good. A little happy valley there. Fire it in like this. Then you. Orange. Something like this. See how nice that works? This play with colors. Have fun. Play with colors. See, it's autumn. Think about autumn time, whatever you. Now we will bring it together some way. We bring it together some way with green, sap green, like this, colors like this. See that? Nice. Try to harmonize. Top, bottom, like top here, higher maybe, fine, on the bottom two here. So that makes it nice. Just harmonize. And you can paint on top of colors, there's no problem. If you don't like something, you can just easy go in and sample here, it looks a bit washed out, then I just put a little bit of shadow side in there and bring it out a bit more. Or the red there, see, I use Alizarin crimson for this one here. See, that brings that tree out again. Use colors, and it's autumn time, and you just bring it out the way you want. A bit in the water here, too. See, and then all of a sudden, you get it all the way you want. Alizarin crimson is a nice color, and the shadow there. See? Maybe here a little bit. That's nice, that dark in the corner there, dark in the water there. Good. Now we fire in the lights. Yellow was here. White, a touch of white into the yellow. It has more power. See, that's good. Oh no, I bring it out. Into the water there. See? Always this, what you see on top, put in the bottom. This is on top here. I will bring it out a bit more. Fire that into the water there. That's good. bit of green here, that tree. And we fired right into the water there too. Always you have whatever's on top, put in the bottom. So very simple, very simple. If you miss some, sometimes you wouldn't even see it. Just be very loose and free. And so now we use a big brush, clean, wash the big brush. Have a nice, clean, dry, clean and dry. Clean and dry. And now you pull it off like this. Push it just down like this. And wash it in between. Make sure you have it nice and clean. Sometimes it is just one or two strokes. See, as a sample now, you saw I have some red came in here because I didn't clean my brush. I showed you how you shouldn't do it. But if it just happened like that, then what you do, see, what I do then, in this case, I just put some on top, see, and put that in here. Now, and then it harmonized again. So that's good, so you wouldn't worry. Just something like this. Clean brush, a dry brush. See, now we go over just very light, very light. And then we make water out of that. See, like this. Oh boy, look at that, how that sure fires out. Now you can make upstrokes here, little upstrokes there. Just on the other side of the water, little upstrokes. See? Now you can create a little creek came in here. Just happened, there's a little creek comes in from here, from far away there. See? Creative power again. Creative power. What a joy. Look at that. Here start off at one point, and all of a sudden that little creek becomes bigger and bigger and bigger. See here? That get darker there. Get darker there. See? Then you can use the colors there. You think autumn leaves are floating off. See, all of a sudden you just let leaves float there. Autumn leaves are floating. Autumn leaves are floating. Isn't that nice how you can really create things? And they can be anywhere. Just let them float. See here, yellow, a bit brighter here, and then you just come to a happy, here make the shoreline on the other side, see, here the same, with autumn colors. And you get a nice, nice autumn scene done. Won't take it too long. Now watch, I take white. I take white here. Just work a little bit on the stream. You must think when the water comes in, it is always moving. Make it move a bit more and let it come in and then it disappears. It relaxes more and more and more and more. How Mother Nature is. You just copy Mother Nature. That's nice, that's nice. Now if you want, you can just easy. See, do those sketches are good. And then just break it up a little bit in between. Break it up a little bit in between. This doesn't show like a long stamp. There you are. You know it doesn't matter. You can just step back and you say, I want it here, I want it there. Maybe here would be nice to have a little bit of a light spot there. Oh, whatever. There. Use a big brush, clean, and make those side moves like this. See, it pushes it. You get the long, you get those long lines in. See, long, long lines coming in. And now I give them the rest, just the highest highlights, here, very bright. Very bright there. So then you can see with what the power that water is coming down. And that is it. Okay, good. How about we call it finish? Good. See the mountain, autumn colors, and that water is running off. You enjoyed it? Thank you for watching me. Bye-bye.